We're back on the air, live. This is Jeffrey Davis from Radio Entrepreneurs, airing all week from Gray, Gray, and Gray with my co-host, Rich Hershen. Rich, we're having a great time. I love it when you guys bring in the food companies.
That's what I was saying before. The best guests are the food guests because they bring presents with them.
And this, you know, this is a particular area of food that I have a great affinity for. Why don't we introduce Jonathan Bassett of Kiklos Olive Oil. Did
correct.
I pronounce it right?
You did.
Kiklos.
Yeah, yeah.
Like Milos, the restaurant.
Like Milos, the restaurant, which I assume is also Greek.
very Greek.
Yeah.
Yes. So, welcome to the show. Tell us about Kiklos.
Well, Kiklos, the word actually means circle in Greek, and it harkens to the, you know, circle of life and circle of the
right.
olive, because every, you know, fall, that's when the harvest begins. But as you are probably aware, a lot of olive oils in the States, you know, they're blended. They're
right, it's not pure.
It's not as pure. It's not great tasting. And we're, you know, those are the ones you can find on store shelves.
And for our listeners, we should know, we did, Rich and I did an olive oil cutting, a tasting before we started.
We did.
We were sipping straight olive oil.
We did shots.
Rich was on the floor for a while, but we got him off the floor. It's kind of a weird guy, this Rich guy. You know, olive oil.
A little strange, but I do know a good olive oil, and that was one.
It was tasty.
How did you get into the olive oil business?
So, as I was saying before, we saw this problem that it's hard to find great tasting olive oil readily available on store shelves, and we being of Greek descent, Greek having grown up here, but been fortunate enough to visit family in Greece and trying the Greek food and falling in love with that, along with other things in Greece that you fall in love with. The staple of that, of the food, is olive oil.
Everything at the base of all Greek foods is olive oil.
At the base of, you know, if your mother or grandmother makes you anything, she's dousing it with olive oil. And it's something I would miss coming back to this, when I come back to the States for school, I would miss that taste, and that's what, you know, that's what starts it. That's what sparks that taste, that flavor.
Sorry, Jeff.
Mm-hmm. So I taste this olive oil. It tastes great, but now this is extra virgin olive oil.
Right.
And there's different categories of olive oil. Can you explain that to me?
So extra virgin in the U.S. is the top grade of olive oil. Then comes virgin. Then comes pomace. So it's really supposed to be, in terms of extra virgin, it's supposed to be free of any defects, the best taste quality, and scientifically, it has to be less than 0.8% of acidity. The problem is, you can get that with olives that are overly ripe and have fallen from the olive tree to the ground, and you can press those and still get extra virgin olive oil. This, Kiklos, however, it has an acidity content of less than 0.3%. We are very meticulous in terms of how we press the olives. We do it before they're overly ripe, before they're too ripe, they're still green. Obviously it's cold pressed, which means you're pressing them under 27 degrees Celsius, which does sound hot. 27 degrees Celsius is
It's about 80.
It's about 80, thank you. But it's, that's actually...
Times 2 at 32.
Thanks. But that's the, you know, that's where you keep the great taste of olive oil when
right.
it's under that temperature. So
and olive oil has nutrient value that other oils don't have, correct?
Yeah, so that's another reason why we chose this type of olive. Well, other than the taste characteristics, this Kiklos has 100% Kotanaki olives. So it's not a blend of different olives from different countries or different regions. This comes from the Peloponnese in Greece. And we only use Kotanaki, which is known as the queen of olives for